Okay, how the fuck do we start these things?
Hello, everyone.
Oh shit, you're right. What did you say?
Hello, everyone.
The look on your face. Hello, everyone.
And welcome back to
Kevin and Dylan 100 Tuesdays. Days.
I was expecting you to keep that weird rhythm.
Oh.
Hello, everyone.
Kevin and Dylan 100 Tuesdays. Pew pew. Pew pew. Nah, I like the radio host, like, Monster Truck Jam announcer voice. By the way, I haven't seen those fucking commercials in forever.
Well, you see, you don't listen to radio.
Do they actually still come on the radio?
All the fucking time.
Really?
Every time there's a Monster Jam.
No, I used to see them on the TV.
Oh, yeah, Monster does it now.
I wonder if that's, like... is that a normal thing in other places, or is that a thing because we live in Texas?
It's a thing everywhere.
Okay. Cool, so everywhere has a shitty redneck Monster Truck Jam. I bet it's the same demographic everywhere, though.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I've gone two times when I was a child, and my parents were like, but I really wanted to see Gravedigger.
I've gone no times, because it always looks stupid as shit.
Well, hey man, that's not cool. So yeah. As you can see from the title of it, that probably picked up on the mic. That probably sounded great. If it didn't, this always is fucking awkward when it doesn't, because we rehear it and then we're like, you could have just not said anything, you fucking idiot.
It's always you.
Whatever. But as you can see from the title, this is another update video. Update again, because why the fuck not, you know? We also couldn't decide on a topic, but we had specific things we wanted to talk about.
Well, you did.
I did. Whatever.
I'm
fuck you.
Some candy hearts.
He is eating some candy hearts.
Because so, I'm yeah. crazy for you.
Our last one came out on Valentine's Day, by the way. Our last 100 Tuesdays.
Crazy for you.
Kevin, stop. And it is currently...
Don't take the video.
Oh, God. It's currently a Tuesday. Today is Tuesday. It's the 28th.
One day's off.
It's been 2 weeks since we uploaded the last one. Not to, like... You know,
dated
or anything, but like we've been moving, so shut up. I don't care.
Suck my dick. You ain't stuff,
dude. We're gonna get copyrighted.
No, I changed the words. We're safe.
Oh, okay.
I saved Christmas.
Yay!
I saved Jewish Christmas.
I saved Jewish Christmas. You know what? We're gonna do a Christmas podcast eventually. And you're going to have to, like, I want to get you a Santa hat.
No, you know
with
what?
The Star of David embroidered on it.
You know what I want to do? I want to do a cinema select on Kiss Saves Christmas because they are all very Jewish.
What?
You've never seen Kiss Saves Christmas?
What? What?
Yeah.
That's a thing.
They rescue Santa.
Oh my God. That sounds fantastic. Anyway, what was I gonna say? Oh yeah, we moved. We're in our apartment now. It's pretty dope. We like it a lot. And so now we can start recording again. Oh wait, no we can't because we're still swamped with hours. Woo! But it's okay.
I started recording my own shit.
Yeah, but it's okay because, like, you know, I work today. But it's the morning and I don't go to work until not right now. So it's fine. I'm cool with doing this. I enjoy this. What are you humming about? What is that?
I'm trying to remember Childish Gambino's name on Community.
Troy.
Troy and Amir in the morning.
Troy and Abed in the morning.
Ahmed.
And Abed in the morning. I wonder if that can be heard outside. We have neighbors.
Oh, definitely.
Jeez. We have neighbors and you know, we live in the city now. This apartment.
I'm not going to call this the city.
What, we live in a city. It's
the
city of...
I wouldn't call it a city. I'd call it a town.
But it's called the city of...
Also, Cleveland's called the city of Cleveland.
You're right. Okay, that's fair.
Believe it or not, Cut and Shoot's a city as well.
No, that one's a town. It's the town of Cut and Shoot.
It depends on the population. I forget the actual math of it.
It's like 1,500, I think. Mm-hmm. But yeah, cool. So we have neighbors, and if you hear noises, shut up. I don't care. That's not even me being edgy. I literally just at this point, I'm like, you know what? Escaping sound is hard. So we just, you know, this is fine.
I'm about to say you're channeling your first video.
Shut up, Kevin. I hate you. That one's gone. It's deleted. Well, it's privated.
Do you like cringe. That,
oh my God.
I don't care.
Kevin, you're hurting me. I'm feeling much pain right now.
You didn't care if I liked the name or not. You hurt me as a fan.
Nobody's a fan of that garbage.
I was.
Oh, so sweet. But yeah.
And literally anyone I ever showed it to, but all, for all the wrong reasons.
It hurts me. I feel the pain. So yeah. Kevin, how do you like your room?
I can jack off and shit.
Well... Me too. In your room.
That's the whack corner. It just smells like fish and crackers.
It's the whack shack. Another thing, we actually don't have Wi-Fi, so podcasts are still pretty much the only thing we can make, because when we edit videos, we like to add stuff in, and without Wi-Fi, you kind of can't get the assets you need and stuff. Mm-hmm. I guess I could download them on my phone, and then transfer them from my phone to the computer, through
yeah,
iTunes,
lazy piece of shit.
Specifically, because you have to do it through iTunes.
No, not if you have an Android. Not shitty iPhone.
I don't have an Android, though.
Yeah, because you got a shitty iPhone.
You're just mad because my phone works and yours doesn't.
I could fix that.
You could fix my phone working?
No, my phone working.
Oh, I was about to be like, are you threatening me? God. But,
I just have to drop yours off a relatively low surface and it'll crack.
Not really. Like, I've dropped this thing so many times. Nah.
You have a case, though.
Yeah, but my cases are, like, thin and flimsy and
yeah,
suck.
But they're rubber.
I guess. So, I think we're going to have to pick another topic to go along with, because...
Dicks.
Okay, well, no.
Some of them are hard, some of them are impotent.
Let's talk about that. You know what? We could talk about, like, 80s cartoons. We did just watch The Brave Little Toaster last night.
That fucking acid trip.
That was, yeah. You know what? I'm cool with this, because you have He-Man up there, and I've been like, maybe we can rewatch He-Man. And,
it's,
like...
It's not the full series.
It was an era of cartoons, like, early cartoons that were just like, what the fuck is
no,
going on?
No, they're not
on?
Early cartoons. Like, the 60s were
oh,
early
well,
cartoons.
Oh, right, you're right, you're right.
This is... Okay, now we know what we're doing, but, like, what are we doing with it? Let's try to sell some toys, I guess, while we figure this shit out.
No, see, let's just talk, you know, old cartoons. That's what we'll call this. We'll call this old cartoons, mm-hmm. right? So, because there's another gem that I just remembered, and it was, well, I say old cartoons, I mean not modern cartoons, you know?
Things
so
we
like,
shouldn't have grown up with, but we saw.
Right, exactly. Like, Aw Real Monsters.
Mm-hmm.
That was actually an acid trip. Like, legitimately. And why did they make that for kids? Like, I think the production company is Klasky Chupo.
No one
I think that's
said
what
it was for kids. They just marketed it.
Well, it was on Nickelodeon.
What does it mean for kids?
Then again, there was a lot of weird, crazy acid trip stuff going on. Like, do you remember the intro? Like, the...
Do you remember what Nickelodeon offices looked like in the 90s?
No. No, I don't.
Google that shit right now.
Okay.
And then compared to now, it's depressing.
Well, explain.
It looks like the Fall of Detroit, the comparison.
Fall of? Detroit was always like
no,
that.
No, it wasn't. Actually, Ernest, he used to go there because he had family there whenever Ernest is my boss at work.
I don't actually know, by the way. I've only been to Detroit once, and I was offered Xanax by a short man in
the
red
course
coat.
Of 10 years, it went from being a booming city like Houston to what it is now. Because he went there when he was like 8. It was great. It was really cool. Big tourist place. And then he went back there when he was like 15. And, like, you saw skyscrapers just fucking abandoned with, like, the top window shattered.
Huh. Interesting.
See? Now look for the pictures of it now.
That does look like it. That's what it is now. Oh, whoa.
It's just, no, that's not it now.
Oh, I don't know.
That's it in the 90s. Now look up pictures of it now.
2017, I guess. Oh.
They took all the cool stuff off.
It's just a green building.
Yeah.
That one's literally just an office building that says Nickelodeon on the side.
Yeah, one side is green. The rest of it is just white office building.
Wow. That actually is depressing.
Yep.
Oh, that's a picture. So...
What?
So... they released some Ren and Stimpy pop figures, and it made me remember, hey, Ren and Stimpy's a thing. I don't know if you've ever watched Ren and Stimpy, Kevin.
Let's pretend I haven't.
Oh, so you have. Okay. Big well, fan. Which Ren and Stimpy did you watch? MTV. Nickelodeon? Or okay. Well.
I saw Nickelodeon, too, and it's better.
I watched the Nickelodeon Ren and Stimpy until my cable got shut off when I was little, because poor, can't pay for cable. And it was when everybody was switching to satellite as well, because that okay. was a thing. And that was when Blockbuster was still around. For those of you kids who don't know what Blockbuster is, kill your... No, Blockbuster was literally the best thing, and I get sad sometimes when I remember that it's not real anymore. Like,
stop fucking bringing it up. You won't remember that as much.
Yeah, but like, whatever. Shut up, Kevin. But I would be like, Blockbuster was a rental video store, if nobody knew. I also got a ton of games there, and like, most of my nostalgic PS2 games were from Blockbuster, because like, they were all really garbage. You know, they were the crappy games, and some of them were good, but like
checked out.
Yeah, exactly. And like now my adulthood is me like, I remember that thing. I can't remember what it's called. I'm going to try to look it up, and then I type it in, and then I figure out the name, and then I look up on price charting, and it's like $80. And I'm like, well, fucking what?
Price charting is not accurate though.
Eh. But, anyway, what was I getting at? Oh goodness!
Shut up!
It's cool. No, we have a shock. We have a shock mount. It's fine.
You brought it up. No, gonna be like, what the fuck again, guys?
Yeah, but you like completely slammed your knee on the table. Are you okay? Okay, that one actually is just a sound. Look at that garbage that you just did. Look at that spiky piece. Anyway, yeah. So Blockbuster Video. I went there. I saw Ren and Stimpy, and I was like, Mom. We can't watch Ren and Stimpy anymore. Please get me this. And I didn't know it was Ren and Stimpy by the name, because it was a different name on MTV. Mm-hmm. So we rented the MTV version. I was very young. And I remember with one scene specifically, it's just ingrained in my mind. And I will attribute this to my sense of humor forever, because I was scarred, but in a good way. And it's a scene where Ren and Stimpy are like, good night, Ren. Good night, Stimpy. And like, they shut off the light. And then the light comes back on. And then Stimpy's like, Ren. And he's just like, oh, Stimpy. And then it's just a scene of them doing it. And then it goes inside of the tent. And you see them pitching a ball and catching a ball in a mitt, which, you know,
pitching it,
pitching and catching. That's it's oh god, it's I was like 9 or 10, maybe younger.
Yeah,
this was very
it came out around the same time. But did you see Rob Zombie's cartoon,
El Super Beasto?
Yes.
No, I have never seen it.
I was like 9.
I've never seen it, and I've always wanted to.
I want
to
own it on Blu-ray. Like, that thing is fucking, like, the point of it was he wanted to make something that looked like a kid's cartoon on the cover.
Yeah.
But it wasn't. It was made specifically for adults.
Yeah, yeah, because there's an actual, like, graphic sex scene in it, isn't there? Oh, multiple.
It opens up with the main character shooting a porno. But the two girls he's fucking, one turns into Medusa, the other one turns into a werewolf while riding his cock. So
I don't see anything wrong with that. That seems normal to me.
He puts the chick that was on his dick up and like cuts her head off with a ceiling fan. And then he reaches into a box that just says box of sex toys and pulls out a dildo and a butt plug and makes a crucifix. And it says "Begone, demon," to Medusa, and she burns because it's a cross. And then he throws them.
Is this part of the shoot, or is this actually happening?
That's actually what's happening. They try to kill him because he fights monsters for a living.
I see. And then
he dives out of the fucking big porn skyscraper, as it's labeled, into his penis car. Is it actually called
Big Porn Skyscraper? If I remember
correctly, yeah. And then he lands into his penis-shaped car and drives to a sex club where he has a multi-titted zombie lady just like spin in a circle, whacking him in the face with tits.
To be fair, the main girl. Every like most women who have tits have multiple, at least two.
I know, but she had like she was like all around her like the titty monster from Resident Evil, but like hot.
I hate the titty monster in Resident Evil. But
they didn't draw it scary. It was like I was strangely aroused for like, a 9-year-old.
That's legit the grossest, like some of the grossest imagery in that game. And there's like
a lot.
That game is only gross imagery.
But, like, seriously, if you ever see that movie, like, it was on Netflix for the longest time, and, like, you see it in DVD bins every now and then, but it hasn't gotten a Blu-ray release yet, and that makes me really fucking upset, because I want the commentary and shit, and they don't, because if you see it, it's in the fucking Walmart $5, there's nothing special on this DVD, this is just the movie, get the fuck over it.
Aww.
I want the commentary, because whenever we saw that on, well, I say we, whenever me... I'm assuming someone else.
Whenever me saw it.
Whenever me saw it, after the movie was over, I was like, what the fuck is this? And then Rob Zombie comes out dressed as a normal human being, which I had never seen of him. And he's like, yeah, so this is actually an artistic project because I wanted to prove to parents that cartoons aren't for kids. They're meant to watch.
Yeah.
And it's like this big speech, and it was like the first time I like saw like an animated thing. This is art. And like at the same time, this art was him like... There's a robot who turns into vehicles for a girl spy agent, but the control shift for him to be seared with is his penis, so he's constantly coming while driving. But, like, he's having to keep it cool because he doesn't want her to know that he likes her.
I see.
So, like, it's like a slapstick, if you will, humor constantly because she, like, has to turn it sharply and shit. And I was like,
And how is this not for kids?
When he climaxes, he makes an oil... She was at the same time wanting to make an oil split behind them. Oil slick. And that legit was his semen. That was his seminal fluid as a robot just all over the... And like, there were other robots chasing them. And they were like, ugh, gross! Because they knew the difference.
I'm now realizing that this robot had semen.
Yeah, it was oil.
Oh...
It was sticky, smelly oil.
Wow.
There's also a really hot cat fight at the end.
I see.
At least that's how everyone makes it, but it's like, I've seen better.
I'm going to have to watch this movie.
Everyone needs to watch this movie.
For research, art.
Like, if I ever find that on Blu-ray, I'm going to like invite people to my house and be like, watch this with me.
And
my
mom's going to be like, I'm not watching this. That's what that means.
We should make my mom watch something fucking awful and make her go on Cinema Select.
Oh, Human Centipede.
No, she liked that movie.
I was like, I don't want to watch
that. She likes
that.
Horror movies.
So that's not really a horror movie. It's like a horror movie in the sense that Resident Evil 6 is a horror game. It's just kind of gross.
Yeah, she likes shit like that.
Ugh. Anyway, so I had something.
At least I think she does.
What was it?
We watched a lot of it growing up.
Brave Little Toaster.
Oh, yeah, fucking...
So...
Everything is a nightmare.
That movie is literally a Toy Story, but it's like a Land Before Time, because it's like a journey. A Land
Before Toy Story.
It's like the Land Before Time, Toy Story, and the fucking acid trip from Dumbo all in one.
The Brave Little Land Before Dumbo.
The Brave Little Land Before Dumbo. That's it. But no, that fucking... Like, nobody's a good person in that movie.
No, everyone treats the fucking... Like, I don't like the Blanky. Like, I would treat the Blanky the same fucking way.
Because it has the most annoying voice in the world. By the way, I remember loving this movie as a child. I still love it. But for different reasons. Exactly. It's like... Wow. It's really a perspective thing. So, you know? Like,
out of, like, classic cartoons, what's your favorite?
Ooh. Well, let's see. What are we talking about? Like, give me a period cap. Like, time period cap.
Late 70s, early 90s.
That's too much of a...
80s.
80s. Okay, my favorite 80s cartoon. Jeez, it's really difficult. I liked Thundercats a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And He-Man. He-Man Masters of the Universe.
Is He-Man is definitely my favorite, because, like,
yeah.
I watched Thundercats. It was cool. Lion-O, I could see some Rule 34 of him.
I like the anime version better. I know it's not an anime, but it's, like, definitely anime-inspired. The 2010 version of Thundercats that got canceled, and I don't know why, because, like, it was such a good version.
It didn't feel like Thundercats to me.
No, of course not, but it was a cool story. Yeah. Like, I actually was interested in the story rather than the animation and characters. Because Thundercats, like, the original... Like, 80s cartoons, like, are mostly, like... it was
about toys.
Yeah, it was all about,
like,
the toys.
Even, like, cartoonists who, like, wanted to do cool stuff, and they went on to work for Disney and shit and do cool artistic shit. But, like, they were like, yeah, they just kind of gave us toys and we had to do shit with them.
Yeah, exactly. And it's like...
No, did you ever see the remake of He-Man that came out in the late 80s, early 90s?
I think so.
He has a ponytail.
Oh my gosh.
We have a copy of, like, Volume 1 box set in the store right now, and I forgot it was a fucking thing, and I forgot how bad it was.
That is awful. Because
it's just as bad animation, but it's 90s bad, not 80s bad.
What's the best 80s cartoon you can think of? One that's actually interesting and that you're actually interested in the story.
He-Man, man.
Well, okay, but, like...
Especially when the time jump happens.
That one's like a villain of the week. Kind of.
Not once,
like,
the time jump happens, it becomes an arcing story.
Really?
Yeah. The last little bit of it right before it got canceled. And a lot of people didn't like it because he started wearing pants and shit. That's where the Hey Ya, like, got most of its clips from, because and he starts living in a mansion. Hey, yeah.
That's probably one of my favorite things to come from He-Man, because I legit enjoy that.
I do too. But,
like, I can watch that video, like, the 10-hour loop that they have of that video, I can watch it. Well.
You gotta get up for work, guys.
Yep. Yeah, mm-hmm. Goes Kevin's phone alarm.
But,
okay.
But favorite?
What's your favorite 90s cartoon?
90s.
This one will be difficult for me.
Nah.
For me.
Courage, Cowardly Dog.
Really?
Yeah, wait, it was either... Courage...
90s or
yeah,
early
it started 2000? In the 90s. It was replay.
I think it was like very end 90s, right? Like 99.
I'm pretty sure it's mid 90s, and it, like, because it got canceled.
I honestly
in the
have
early
no clue.
2000s.
That's why I'm gonna, like, I want to look it up, because, like, I'm gonna look mine up too and make sure that it's like.
And, like, it was tied between that and Dexter's.
Oh, dang it! Now I can't decide, because I was gonna say Ed, Edd n Eddy. But, like,
you
once again, still not sure if that's early
2000s. Ed, Edd n Eddy, it started in late, like, 99, if it started in the 90s. But, yeah. It went on until,
no, yeah,
like...
Courage released 1999 and was over 2002. Let's see, Ed, Edd n Eddy. When did that come out? It might have been not 90s. But I love Ed, Edd n Eddy.
Yeah, but that's, like, hitting, like,
so good.
The golden age of cartoons, like, right before it was overarching cartoons.
When you actually, like, yeah.
It was still, like, this is the episode for the week, but it was, like, it was good.
Right.
Like, Grim Adventures.
Yep, 1999 as well.
Yeah. But, there was a customer that came in my store the other day, and he did his own tattoo, but, like, usually it's like, oh, that's shitty.
Yeah,
he shouldn't have done that, but he did a, right on his forearm, he did a mural to all the old school, like, Cartoon Network cartoons.
Yeah.
And he was he had all this colored, and he was stretching onto the back of his arm, and he had all the line work done for the new school,
mm-hmm.
Regular Show, Venture Time, Steven Universe.
Right,
like, he was adding them because he liked them so much.
Yeah.
Because he's cool. A dude in his, like, 40s.
Yeah.
So, like, it was really rad.
Jeez. Yeah, no, Dexter's Lab. Oh, God.
Yeah, but for me, it's definitely either Courage or Dexter's. I'm going to say Courage because, like, that has influenced my art.
Yeah. Yeah, your art is terrifying most of the time.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even, like, no cartoons that I watch have influenced my art, honestly. Like, I just say
Ben 10 does, especially with your eyes.
Ben and then, 10? Like, I don't know how to draw eyes, more... so I just do them.
Yeah, it reminds me of his pupils, though. But, whenever you started doing, like, more realistic... I don't want to say realistic, because it's still cartoony. That's just what you do.
I started doing characters. Yeah, you started doing
characters and shit.
But, I'm trying to get back into drawing, like, just... because I've been having, like, major artist's block. So I'm like, you know what? If I start, like, doing some more surrealistic, like...
I just do shit.
Like, draw, like...
I don't even plan when I start putting a line on the paper. It just kind of becomes tits and shit.
Oh, well.
And some mostly landscapes, but, you know, yeah. I don't show those off because they're landscapes and boring.
Yeah, I mean... I see something, and then I'm like, wow, that sounds like it would be cool or fucked up. I honestly can't tell. And then I draw it, and I'm like...
Fucked up.
Can't share that with mother.
Like, that always, like, really irritated people, like, when I was still in art class. I don't plan what I'm going to draw. Like, Renner's like, okay, what are you doing? I don't know yet. Ask me in a week when there's kind of a picture there.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. And she was like... And it's like, I never paid attention to, in her class. Like, I will straight up say that. And she knows it. My daily work stuff that I do for art class reflects it. But I was really good with pen and ink. And, like, mm-hmm. I didn't follow any of the rules for pen and ink. And it made her mad. So she eventually just started leaving me to my own devices because it turned out better.
Nice. Okay. So, if you could choose any cartoon... besides the ones you've already named, to get a revival series based upon, like, story, not, like, one that would you think would last now, what cartoon would that be?
With this said, I usually don't like reboot series of them trying to redo stuff.
Not like, a reboot, a continuation.
A continuation, same team, same animation style?
Yeah.
Game Adventures of Billy and Mandy.
Yeah, I straight up think that would be...
like, if not Teen Titans, but, like, that kind of happened.
Like, I need some more, like, dark comedy cartoons, like, yeah. Some edgy, like, goth
Steven
humor.
Universe is cool, but, like, I want to see Mandy rule the world again.
Steven Universe is cute, makes me feel warm and fuzzy, but I want Billy and Mandy makes me feel like...
I want to see someone's, like, face get ripped off and yeah. be able to laugh at that and it'd be socially acceptable.
Yeah, exactly. It made crazy, like, Invader Zim is another one that I think...
I don't...
If it got a revival now, I think it would be successful.
I don't think it would be because, like,
really?
Nickelodeon's not going to hire the original creator.
No, not, like, it doesn't have to be Nickelodeon, right? It's like, we're keeping creators out of it. Mm. It's purely, right now, it's purely, like, based upon, you know, society and like, I
still
don't,
feel like
I don't
the
know.
Way they do, like, like continuations now, because, like...
Well, we're talking about, like... It's exactly the same.
Mm-hmm.
It's not no studio involvement. It's the show continued. But do you think it could last now rather than when it was out? Not based upon the studio, but based upon the fan base.
With Invader Zim.
People watching it.
Because, like, that's a nostalgia boner. Like, I'm going to straight up say that because, like, really? I rewatched it. I like the animation, but, like...
I think the joke still hit. And it still creeps me out, too, and
that's,
I like that.
Yeah, that's the animation part of it, but, like, the story doesn't. Like, it's...
It's silly.
It's silly, and, like,
but
it
the
gets
silly,
old fast.
In my opinion, the silliness, like, greatly contrasts the creepiness, which makes it work. That's what I think. But...
I think it'd be, like, everyone would be super hyped for it for, like, the first season or so.
I get
and then
that
it would
it
die
is a,
out,
it
like,
is a niche
shortly
thing,
after.
Yeah.
Like, there'd be the niche people that get pissed when it gets canceled again. But
somebody's
like,
getting arrested.
I hope they can't hear that and you're just sounding stupid.
Oh, there's police sirens in the background if you can't hear it. If you can hear it, shut up, Kevin. I hate you.
but I feel like around season two, most of the fan base will drop off, ignore it like they did Doctor Who. And then...
No, you know what? Okay. You know what I would really love?
What?
You know the last season of Ed, Edd n Eddy? When they got really serious and dramatic.
Yeah, and they were in school and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was my favorite season of Ed, Edd n Eddy.
I hated it.
What?
Yeah.
Why?
I was bored.
What?
Like, I would turn it on, like, I like Ed, Edd n Eddy. And, like, I felt tired, but, like, I wasn't tired. It's just, I was tired of this.
Oh, my gosh. I
really liked the movie that came out right at the end, though. Of them trying to find his brother. Because he's so cool.
No, yeah, and no, it's fine. His
brother's a shithead.
Yep, mm-hmm. Yeah,
but, whatever. But, like, that season, I just was not into.
I'm not personally offended or anything.
Fuck off.
Oh. No, I that's fair, I guess.
Because I really like the Scam of the Week feeling episodes where it's like, yeah. Okay, how are we going to fuck everyone over? That's and then whenever much. They went to school,
it's well, because... Well, it's not even like they were like, let's fuck everyone over. It's like, how are we going to get jawbreakers? I don't care who I fuck over in the process. And it's like, wow. That's their motivation.
Yeah. And then with that last one, like, you could argue that, like, it took more of a creative process to write those episodes.
Yeah.
But at the same time, the heart of the show was,
that being simple, terrible people.
Terrible people for such a simple thing that's not that hard to get.
Eddie being a terrible person and the other two going along with it.
They went along with it. They're just as bad. But this isn't they fucking were for Germany. Sure,
they were humanizing Eddie a little more.
Yeah.
And I personally liked that just because I think that's always like that's always my favorite thing. When you can make a character more relatable for me, I'll actually be like I'll care about the character.
But my problem is I related more to Eddie whenever he was just a shitty person for simple things because that was me as a kid. I was a shitty person because I wanted your Yu-Gi-Oh cards.
Well, yeah, he was.
That's it.
He was still, you know, shitty.
Yeah,
but he was just like they gave him repercussions for his shittiness.
I didn't want repercussions. I just wanted to see him do it every week. And they gave him repercussions in the original ones. He always got hurt, like, really bad.
Right, but he'd still be like, I totally want to make a fort, like a secret base out of a bush. And, yeah. Like, that was actually a really funny episode.
Mm-hmm.
There's so much interesting kid imagery. Speaking of, codename Kids Next Door. Oh!
That was good.
That's one where I actually legitimately cared about the characters, and when they got story...
That one, I like, really liked. Like, I really liked the development of it being a villain of the week, and then all those villains of the week came together, made the fucking adult organization, and the teens were introduced by then, and yeah. It was just a big fucking war. And
yeah.
It's like, shit, man, how could this get even better? Oh, have you ever heard of Agent Zero?
Oh, my God.
It's
like,
ah, fuck you. Who's Agent Zero? It's the dopey dad? No fucking way.
Oh, my gosh.
Spoilers
for a 10-year-old show. I wouldn't want that one to come
back, though. I wouldn't want that one to come back.
Cause, like, I
want to
rewatch it.
I would rewatch it, but like, I really liked how it ended. If it came back, it would have to be a complete reboot.
What's something you'd drop a bunch of money on? Like, if they had, like, a box set? No, like, if they had a box set. Like my Persona box set that has the Blu-ray, the DVD, and all of the knickknacks that come with it.
Mm-hmm.
What would you drop legitimate money on, like an old cartoon like
yeah,
that?
I'm thinking.
Like, based He-Man. Upon, like, you for sure would watch it over and over and over, He-Man. But you would also like the collectible stuff. You already have a box set for
No, He-Man. I have season one.
Oh, well, whatever.
I don't. The whole like, box set of it's, like, a whole shelf long.
Right.
It's, they push that toy line fucking hard. Thank you, Bandai.
But yeah, so what else besides He-Man, I guess?
The Courage box set's pretty dope. It's like $90.
Oh, they actually have one.
Yeah, and it comes, you know, the...
Let's think of non-existing box sets.
Non-existing box sets? Yeah. Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy, because I've actively searched for that. And you can get the Grimm and Friends, Volume 1 through 6, but it doesn't have all the fucking episodes.
I hate those.
And it's
I hate those.
And it's also not just Grimm. It's other shows also. God. And it's like, fuck you.
Yeah, and, like, they have, what's his name? The bear. The bear with the brain and the stomach. And it's like, I actually enjoyed that one, but that one goes with Billy and Mandy. That's fine.
Yeah.
You know, Hector Concarne, that's the guy's name. Mm-hmm. But, like, Evil Concarne was the show. But the Billy and Mandy and Friends, those are shows not even related to Billy and Mandy. It's like
Friends.
It's completely what different friends? Things. They don't have friends. No, our only friend is Grimm.
And like I thought they were gonna do it the way they were advertising their shows, like in between commercials.
Mm.
I really wanted a fake reality show of the Cartoon Network town because I think that'd be hilarious.
That would be
like Cartoon Network, get on that shit. Like a lot
like
of them
drawn
are...
together, but with Cartoon Network characters.
Because I thought they were gonna do that because around the time they were doing those in between skits, they had the like the Total characters Drama Island and shit.
Oh, that was
They also were doing regular reality shows, and I was like, fuck, they're gonna do this, and they never did.
I can't tell if that show is a guilty pleasure.
I think
or
it's
not.
A guilty pleasure because like I've rewatched it and I hate it.
No, like I've rewatched it and I still like it, but like I'm learning that a lot of people actually did like that show and they watched it but they didn't talk about watching it
because you know like they made pee jokes and shit.
Yeah, it was terrible, raunchy, but like it was a great satire. Yeah. Like
it was a great satire.
It's a great satire on reality TV.
It's just
right?
I don't like reality TV that much.
Yeah, but like
so like even sat like it's not even something I like have fun just like usually when I see satire I want to see satire of things I like to talk shit about.
What about Drawn Together?
Yeah, Drawn Together I like because...
That one wasn't the same way because it was more like Big Brother instead of the challenge stuff.
And, well, Big Brother does challenges and shit.
Oh, does it really?
Yeah.
Oh,
everyone just watches for the not challenge shit. That's how they figure out who gets voted out of the house.
Then it's more like The Real World.
Yeah, right? And like the reason I liked Drawn Together so much was because I didn't like the satire of it being a reality show. I liked the satire of each individual cartoon character. They had the anime. They had the fucking... I don't even know what you would call Foxy, to be honest. I don't know what she's supposed to satire, but she's black, and I like it.
Oh, you don't know what she's supposed to be?
No.
She's a mystery solver.
Mm.
She's a Scooby-Doo. Just look at her eyes. Yeah, that's it. It's the eyes that give it away. But she's like a Josie and the Pussycats, you know, sexually exploited, but also like that period of animation, like
that
60s.
That period that still happens. Totally Spies.
Right.
Skin tight suits.
Totally Spies, that still happens. That was from like 2000 and like
they kept going until like 2010 or so. They were still making different versions of it.
I enjoyed that show a lot,
I did too.
Actually.
Sam is bae.
Yeah. I liked Alex, the yellow suited one. Because mm-hmm. she's the bubbles, you know? Yeah. Oh, Powerpuff
she's more,
Girls.
I wouldn't call her the bubble. She's more of like the Chie. She's the athletic,
yeah.
like, sporty
No, that's exactly
one.
What she reminds me of, actually. Chie's... The reason why Chie is best waifu is because she is Spy Ninja waifu. You can tell because yellow... Persona got all of its inspiration from Totally Spies.
Totally happened.
Confirmed.
They investigate shit.
Yeah. Oh.
But
they have a
you know
butler.
What, you know what? As a cartoon, Wait. I think everyone should see while it's still on Netflix.
Hmm.
Like I'm a little biased because Star Trek, but the Star Trek cartoon from the 1970s, you shouldn't watch it because it's good. You shouldn't watch it because it's super bad. You should watch it because it was Nimoy's like playground. They let him do whatever the fuck he wanted with that show, and he was the main writer. So like it's literally things that they're like nah this isn't going on Star Trek so he put it in the cartoon and it was great.
That's beautiful.
It's and like they have the original cast voice acting for it and it's just you could tell it's just Nimoy being like I'm a fuck with some shit in this universe because he's the main character of the cartoon even though they try to make it look like Kirk he gets all the best lines.
Nice. Okay, so you know how Disney for a while did a lot of those, like...
Look at this demographic.
No. This was a movie we made. Here's a TV show for it. Or for the side character. Or this or that.
Yeah.
Which one was your favorite? Because there were some actual good ones
that
I
liked. The Hercules one.
I was thinking the Hercules one, but Buzz Lightyear of Star Command...
Oh, fuck, I forgot
about
that one.
Hands down, one of the best animated...
It got ended, like, fast, though.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it was also a villain of the week, like, overblown superhero, mm-hmm. but I enjoyed it so much.
The animation was cool.
Yeah, the animation was fantastic. And, like, the blue girl, Mira, I think was her name.
Hot.
Well, she also had a cool character, and I just liked her in general. Okay, Nova was her name. Nova, that's what it was. But my favorite, and, like, it wasn't even a Disney movie... Right?
Mm-hmm.
It's just a person. An actual person. Do you know what I'm talking about?
No.
Jackie Chan Adventures. I love the Jackie Chan Adventures so much. Oh my gosh.
That's something I would like a box set on, but you can't find it.
It's so hard. And like the discs individually, are so expensive.
Though, there's a big market of bootlegged ones, and I'm kind of tempted because they stepped their game up on that shit. It's not just shitty DVDs.
Well, I'll have
they to make, look They into make custom it. Box sets for it, and I'm kind of into it.
I'm legit. Like, I would love rewatching that series so much because Jade was an awesome character. I loved her. She was great comedy relief, but, like, everyone was comedy relief because it's a comedy action.
I mean, it's a Jackie Chan.
It's a Jackie Chan. The person who voiced Jackie Chan was awesome. He didn't sound like Jackie Chan, to be honest. But he did at the same time.
My like ringtone all throughout middle school was
bad day.
And then my text tone was the uncle Uji. I can't remember it.
Uji Mike Wi-Fi Chow.
Yeah, and so like if someone called me, it was just Jackie going bad day, and then the uncle casting spells on him. I got made fun of for it because it was loud and obnoxious.
I liked all the side characters. I liked the villains. I loved the powers. The powers were so freaking cool.
I was
cool.
So fucking happy because like they had a toy line for that. And I'm pretty sure... what's their name? They're the ones who do the Halo ones now. It'll come back to me. But they released a... gauntlet thing that you put that came with, like, you're supposed to collect all the stones, but I got it whenever like it went on sale at Walmart. And I got one of all the stones and I had all of them. I was like, fuck yeah,
that's cool.
I had it until like we moved out of some apartments in Conroe, ironically enough.
Yeah.
And I can't remember if it didn't get packed or like what, but I didn't have it, and I would love to have that on display now because that was a cool looking gauntlet.
Yeah, we'll have to look it up. You know what I want really bad, but they're freaking crazy expensive now?
Dual disc?
Yes, a dual disc. My sister broke mine.
My little cousin took it apart. Yeah, Alex, I'm still mad about that. Grandma made me say it's okay. Fuck you.
Yeah. Fuck you, Alex. I'm not even upset about the dual disc, you know, of Kevin's.
He just wants to say fuck you, Alex.
That, and also, I can't say that to my sister yet. Because my mom would get mad.
I mean, if Grandma ever heard that, she'd be like, really? Really, Kevin? Really? And it's like obvious sarcasm, but like she wouldn't get that.
But also, I'm legit mad about it because that means Kevin doesn't have a dual disc and I want one.
So fuck you, Alex.
Exactly.
I really hope he's in a good mood when he sees this and isn't like, oh my god, what?
Okay, so let's see. Is Avatar The Last Airbender, is that old enough to talk about yet?
I wouldn't, because it ended like way fucking late. It was like going on.
I guess. I just love it. You know, like it started airing before I was in high school.
Yeah, but it stopped airing while you were in high school.
We need to set a cap for old cartoons, damn it.
I thought the cap was like 2000s and stuff, things that like everyone our age talks about, but
I guess.
Then we started talking about shit.
I just like Avatar. Honestly, I don't have anything specific to say about it. I just love Avatar.
Yeah.
Like, book one is okay. Like, it's fantastic, but compared to the other books, no, it's okay.
While we're, like, still in, like, the golden years of Cartoon Network.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What you got for me?
Hi, Puffy Ami Yumi.
Hi, Puffy Ami Yumi Show! Hi, Puffy Ami Yumi Show! No.
I bought the CD.
Hi, Puffy Ami Yumi just reminds me, because I honestly don't remember that much of the show. I remember
it
Kaz.
Was fucking great.
I remember them. But do you know what I remember? Is that they did the theme song for
Teen Titans.
Teen Titans.
That's why they got a cartoon, and I love it.
The original Teen Titans is so, so, so good, and it makes me... Well, okay, everything up until the last season. The last season just confused me, because it felt so disjointed from the rest of the series. And, like, the cliffhanger at the end is just like, really, bruh? Like, really? I know you tried to tie everything up with the movie, but that had nothing to do with Terra. What happened? If you haven't watched all of Teen Titans or any of it, like, sure, you won't understand that, but also, why? You suck and I hate you?
Terra's the rock lady, right?
Yes, Terra's the rock lady. The rock lady. But no,
fuck,
I just...
Terra.
Like my favorite arc for that is like when Raven gets more backstory and character, and it's like, ugh.
My favorite arc for that's when they go to Japan.
That was the movie.
Yeah, mostly just because it shows that Beast Boy's a fucking weeb and I related to him as a human being.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I related to him
like,
before
as
that,
I'm an
too.
Adult, as an, like, yeah, I'm a comedian, but as an adult, I realized Beast Boy is the fucking creators. Like, his character is the fucking creators. They're just, like, Japanese shit and nerdy as fuck and, like, making jokes.
That's why, like, Teen Titans Go, it's funny. I enjoy watching it, but it makes me really sad because the creators, the team behind Teen Titans Go has never even watched the original series.
I'm sure they have now. They probably got some shit for saying that.
I mean, probably, but, like, I feel like they have a team, like, the writers that maybe watched it, but I honestly don't know. I just know that, like, when they said that, that's disappointing. Watch the series, that way you can make better jokes, because they do have some nods back to the old series. But I'm wondering if they just have notes, you know? Somebody took notes for them on characters and on the story. And it's like, ugh, but it was so good. Just make more of that. And then they do the joke episodes where they go back to the original animation and they're like, haha, remember when this was a thing and how many people want it?
And then they pull it out from
screw
under you.
Screw you guys. And it's like,
yeah,
dude, come on. What?
No, it's something I always wanted a shitty cartoon for, but like a good shitty cartoon.
Huh.
Terminator. Because like
I want a continuation of the Sarah Connor.
Yeah, Sarah Connor Chronicles is fucking dope, but we're not talking about cool dramas.
True.
House isn't coming into this conversation.
Like House.
Though if House had a cartoon, it'd be fucked up. But yeah.
Were there any like weird dramatic cartoons that were like, this shouldn't be a thing?
Speed Racer. That's not a cartoon. That shouldn't be a thing.
No, the remake for Speed Racer. That was a cartoon.
I liked that, though.
All of the Nickelodeon CG cartoons looked awful.
Yeah.
I heard that the Iron Man one was okay.
The Iron Man one I didn't think looked awful. I really liked the art style for the Iron Man one.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't watch it.
My only complaint is it's weird Tony Stark being a teenager. Oh. Like, don't try to make him relatable. He's a Playboy billionaire. Shut up.
The Spectacular Spider-Man, which is the old, or no, The Amazing Spider-Man and His Friends, that's what it was, based off the Spectacular Spider-Man comics. That show sucked. I liked it.
Yeah.
But it was like one of those like...
My favorite version of Spider-Man in cartoons was probably Ultimate Spider-Man.
Oh, that, yeah, like, that one's kind of new though.
It started like well before high school. They made it two versions of it. There's Ultimate Spider-Man. And there's, like, Ultimate Spider-Man with a subtitle on it. It's where they, because at first it was Villain of the Week.
I want that to be the subtitle.
And,
Ultimate Spider-Man with a subtitle on it.
but the original one was the one that I really like. And it's where it's, like, it's like when you read the comics, like, the beginning of him before he started working with villains and shit.
Yeah.
Where it's just, like, this is a villain. This is what he does. This is his motive. Now he has to stop him. And it was... I'm seeing that really that was them getting the introductions out of the way so they could make what they wanted to make, which was the second series, which I always forget the name to. And that's
the
where
Ultimate
like
Spider-Man with a subtitle on it.
Yeah. And that's why that's when they start introducing the multiple universes with the multiple Spider-Man. Venom starts working with him. Like Flash learns to control Venom and that gets really cool. And like, it's really
you
cool.
You said Flash.
Yeah. The football player.
Oh, Flash. Oh, Flash Thompson.
Yeah.
I thought you meant, like,
the
Barry
Flash.
Allen.
That's the because
Flash.
You've been watching too much of it.
Whatever, shut up.
And, like, so that was a really fucking cool Spider-Man cartoon. If you've never seen that, you do it. Fucking do it.
I also really like the Spider-Man, where he's in the future, where there's, like, a bunch of mutated human, like, animal hybrids.
Yeah.
I
like to think that they're in the same city as the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and they just run into each other every now and then.
That'd be so cool.
Because they did the same gimmick.
Oh, Turtles in Time.
Yeah.
Or no. That's not what it was called. That was the video game. What was the show called?
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Rewind or Fast Forward or something
like
that?
Fast Forward.
Yeah. That one was awesome. But like that entire series.
Was awesome.
Yeah. Honestly, one of my favorite theme songs. Like, Kevin and I... At one point in time, I don't know, like a couple of months ago when we got back from working up north.
That was almost a year ago, like half a year now.
Jeez. I remember, like, it just popped in my head, and we both started singing the Turtles theme song for no reason. It's like,
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles,
Turtles
counting off.
1, 2, 3, 4, Turtles. There's no one better.
Turtles.
Watch out for Shredder.
Turtles.
Turtles. I don't know the actual, like, I don't know the
I don't know them right now, but like we did in that moment, and it was cool.
It's a good show.
You want to know something funny, audience? I want to be the very best.
Like no one ever was. Catch them as my road test. Train them in my cars. I would travel across the land. 13, 4, and wine. It was my destiny. Pokemon, oh, you're my best friend. In a world that I hate you, Kevin. A heart so true. Our courage will pull us through. You teach me and I'll teach you.
Pokemon.
Gotta catch them all. Gotta catch them all. Pokemon.
Gotta catch them all because he's Danny Phantom.
Gotta catch them all because he's Danny Phantom. Damn it, Kevin. I don't have to. Yo, Danny Phantom, he was just 14 when his parents built a very strange machine. It was designed to view a world unseen. He's gonna catch them all because he's Danny Phantom. I'm good at that. I'm good with that.
You sure?
There's a couple trigger songs.
Just quit. Then Danny took a look inside of it. There was a great big flash. Everything just changed. His molecules got all rearranged. Danny Phantom, when he first woke up, he realized he was snowy white hair and glowing green eyes. He could walk through walls, disappear, and fly. He was much more unique than the other guys. It was then that he knew what he had to do. He had to stop all the ghosts that were coming through. He's here to fight for me and you. He's gonna catch them all because he's Danny Phantom. Gonna catch them all because he's Danny Phantom.
Want to know one that's gonna trigger you?
No, I love Danny Phantom.
We just another about. Day in the life of a boy. Johnny Tips. Johnny Tips.
Stop it.
Johnny Tips.
No.
I fucking hate that cartoon.
Just right. Another day in the life of a boy. Just another day in the life of a boy. Just another day in the life of a boy. Johnny Tips.
See, what I hate about that cartoon is it started off strong, like, yeah, this could be a cartoon. And that was season one. And then they switched off the writing team and the animation team to this weird fucking swooshy, like, use the whip sound effect every third movement.
Yeah.
And it's like, come on, man.
It went from being on WB and it got bought by Cartoon Network.
Come on, man. You can do better. Like, fuck you, Johnny.
Oh, God, that was a thing. What? Oh, God. Do you remember that era of, like, teen cartoons?
Yeah, where everything had to be dramatic. And
around when Total Drama came out,
yeah.
They had, what was it called? I think it was called 16, I think is what the...
Yeah, the same group did
16,
it.
16, when you're growing up so fast.
Yeah.
It sounds too fast. Yeah, because the... One of so, the characters, the if... only, like... You know, the dumb, goofy, shaggy,
yeah,
beast boy, stoner character is the same voice that does the host from Total Drama.
Mm-hmm.
And I recognize that.
I don't know if you realize that was also a satire.
It was.
90210 and shit like that.
No, yeah, I know. Oh, I know about 90210, Kevin. Didn't you know I'm named after a character, or rather an actor? Wait, was the character's name Luke or was the actor's name Dylan? Whatever. I'm named after somebody from 90210, and it's like, am I named after Bob Dylan? No, not a good musician. Nope, I'm named after a soap opera.
Soap opera. Choose a dialect.
Soap opera. I don't know, man. I didn't sleep much.
Yeah. Cartoons are rad. I watched a lot of them.
Yeah.
So, like, when I was a kid, like, I remember actively having the thought, and it sounds super childish to me and makes me giggle at myself, but like as a kid I would have the words pop in my head when things live action came on. Ugh, adult shows. And then I was like, I want to watch kid shows. Like I was like that until I was like, those words popped in my head, as childish as they sound, until I was like 15 and I was like, wait a minute, hold on,
there's something here.
That's not how you make words, Kevin. Yeah. I still look at cartoons more than I watch live action shit, though. Like, I really like House and stuff, but, like,
You can't beat Three Stooges the cartoon, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I want to see people get pies thrown in their face and shit. And then jack off to it, you know?
If you had to pick one cartoon to watch over and over and over and over, like, you can only, like, if you're watching a cartoon, it can only be that cartoon.
Johnny Quest.
Oh, Johnny Quest. I thought you said Johnny Test for a second.
No, what Johnny Test was a pun of.
Oh, never liked Johnny Quest.
I choose Johnny Quest because it's such a long series that I'll forget the episodes and I can just watch it on loop. I may not like them the best, but, like, I'll forget about the old episodes because, like, it's forgettable.
The way you think about things is weird.
The way you think about things is weird. I'm the normal one. Prove me wrong. Pixar didn't happen. Cash me outside. How about that?
Ooh! That's something we haven't talked about. I just looked over at the Xbox games and saw it, and I was like, The Simpsons. Yeah, I love The Simpsons. I haven't watched... What?
I did not... I never liked the show. I've liked the movie. I liked the games. I get so fucking bored during the television show. And, like, I know that's an unpopular opinion, because, like, it's, like, I remember in fucking elementary school, on the tax test, we did a paper talking about how The Simpsons have had 100 episodes now, and that's fucking amazing.
I'm actually upset by this news.
I mean, I like Futurama and shit that was, like, dirty, raunchy humor. That was very tame, and everyone, like, hyped it up to be this, like, edgy-ass fucking comedy, and I was like, I was super underwhelmed.
It was when it came out.
It was super tame. I've seen season one.
You know, that upsets me, because I know you like Family Guy.
Okay, no, I don't even like Family Guy. I like Seth MacFarlane.
Okay, that's fair. I do like Seth MacFarlane.
Because, like, he's a funny motherfucker. Especially, have you seen his stand-up?
I just like his voice a lot.
Fuck. His stand-up was, like, I'm disappointed in him for, like, making shows and shit instead. Because he could have killed that career.
Yeah.
Because his first tour was with Louis C.K. when Louis C.K. had hair.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, that's how fucking long ago he did stand-up.
I feel like he looks like George from Seinfeld with hair and skinnier.
A little bit.
Because, like, I was like, huh, I wonder what he looked like then. And I just thought of George Costanza with, like, you know, hair coming out here and on the top. And then I was like, wait.
Yeah, because, like, I
that's
fucking...
That's not Seth MacFarlane.
Like, I like Seth MacFarlane because he does jokes I like. He just makes fun of people who made fun of him, pretty much. And, like, that's what his stand-up was. That's what most of his, like, shows that he does besides Family Guy.
That's his shtick.
That's his shtick. He just makes fun of people, make fun. That's why there's so many fucking Jew jokes in Family Guy. He straight up is rehashing the ones that were told to him.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, he doesn't like them, but he knows other people will. That's what Family Guy is. He doesn't necessarily like the humor, but he knows it'll go over well with the general audience. And he uses the money from Family Guy to make the shows he was really into.
Like American Dad?
He wanted to make American Dad before Family Guy.
Apparently. That makes sense to me, because American Dad, like, I think, is so much better.
American Dad doesn't care if you like the jokes. It's American Dad because it wants to be American Dad.
I love how mean-spirited most of the characters are.
Yeah.
Like, at some point, they're all so, like, mean-spirited.
Like, Family Guy, especially at this point, it's no longer, like, an expression of him as a creator. It's just, like, this is a show that I'm doing.
Like,
it has that feel.
And Family Guy, like, sure, the bit where everyone hates Meg, that's fine, whatever. But, like, everyone hates everyone in that family at some point in time.
It's like
an American Dad.
It's like a
and
tame
it's...
Rick and Morty. Everyone just hates everyone, and, like, they do shit.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
And I love that.
Rick and Morty's more real, though. I don't know.
Yeah, Rick and Morty's
better. For some reason,
better.
The show about, like, space and time and you know, crazy stuff happening feels more real when it comes to the actual drama to me.
Yeah. But, like, I like his other shit that he does. But, like, and I really like how the voice actors for Family Guy, like, they kind of have the same feel at this point where they just kind of say shit and, like, they'll improv things because, like, whatever. But, what's his face? Green. Seth Green? Is his name also Seth?
Yeah, Seth Green.
All right. He would write jokes for Robot Chicken, and they would reuse them in Family Guy because they know it's just a general populist thing.
Yeah, yeah.
And Robot Chicken has a niche culture following it.
See, I love Robot Chicken as well. Oh, yeah, that one's technically an old cartoon, too.
Yeah. It's fucking good.
It is.
Do you remember the fucking Alien and Caveman cartoon?
No.
It came on in between Nickelodeon cartoons, and it was a stop-motion cartoon about an alien trying to teach a caveman cool shit. But the alien always gets fucked up, because the caveman fucks it up. It was like,
I remember
Earl and Bob or something like that.
I remember this. Oh, I do remember that.
Yeah.
It was like the fat bottom.
It was the fat bottom and fucking
skinny.
Yeah, and then alien. The alien's like a needle guy. Something else. Just Google like Earl and Bob Nickelodeon alien cartoon thing. And it was like it was them experimenting, and like it was just funny as fuck. It would come on in between sessions of that not Kids Next Door, Kids Next Door thing. You know the one with the lobster claw guy? You
said Nickelodeon.
Oh, not my bad. Was it? It was Cartoon Network. My bad.
Okay. That makes a little more sense. I'm starting to see it a little more.
And, like, his head looks a lot like this, like, portable phone charger thing. Like, imagine this is his head, and he has a body that's equally as thin, and he's like, nyeh. And they just make, like, those noises, and the caveman's like, ooh, okay. And it sounds like they had one guy just make noises, because, like, it was just fucking whatever this is.
I mean, Dee Bradley Baker, literally his entire career is making noises.
Yeah, you're right.
I love him so much.
But, like, someone who's not talented making noises. So, that was a cool cartoon.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was Earl and Bob. I might be wrong on that, though.
I do remember the crazy, like, fucked up Nickelodeon stop-motion cartoons, though. Like, the one where the kid turned himself inside out by flipping on the swing.
Yeah. That scared me.
I never got on a swing again.
Oh, well, no, okay, I did. I was hoping.
But, like...
I was like, please end it.
Oh, my God. Anyway.
But,
Any closing thoughts, Kevin? Why are you silent?
Thinking.
Cartoons are rad. Thank you for laughing at that. Cartoons are rad. We're at our new place, and it's also rad.
We are also turning 21 this year and still like cartoons.
Yeah. Shut up. If you don't like cartoons, you suck. And that's your opinion. And it's wrong.
No, so, okay. No, this is an actual closing thought.
Yeah.
Fucking when parents like put on just cartoons because they think cartoons are for kids. Fuck those guys. Fuck those parents. You're a shitty parent.
Yeah.
Like, I'll straight up tell you. You're a shitty parent if you're one of those.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it. That's directed to a lot of people at my family in particular, but I know there's more.
Okay, everyone. Well, I guess thank you for watching, and we will see you guys next time when we become actual cartoons in Rocko's Modern Life. That was a good one. Go watch it.
I just want to cut it. Rocko's Modern Life.
Bye.
Fucking cat dog.
Oh, shit. Cat dog.
Bye. Just like go into it, like I name another obscure cartoon and fight over who gets to say bye last. You're trying to think of another one.
No. Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends. That's I like that one. That was my favorite cartoon for a long time.
The same.
Boo doop doo 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 boo doop doo.
The fucking intro to that, like the drawing. Oh, fuck. We're just gonna have to fade out because we can't stop talking about this. Boop boop. Fucking Hey Arnold. Bye. Bum 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 bum. Oh, fucking Sassafras. Remember that one? No.
Cool. Oh, Scooby-Doo. Shit. Scooby.